Whether you do snowball, avalanche, velocity banking, question is, which one is more efficient? Efficient doesn't always necessarily mean that I'm gonna pay it off faster. Doesn't always necessarily mean that. But in my eyes, efficiency means fastest, in my eyes. But I can understand how this can be very confusing to an individual. So therefore, what happens to velocity banking? If this stuff flies over your head, if you just can't get it, no matter how many times I watch Denzel's videos, it's just too confusing. This is no longer efficient. So therefore you would want to do a snowball. That means you close your eyes to interest rates, you close your eyes to cash flow, you close your eyes to income opportunity, you close your eyes to everything, and all you focus on is the smallest debt, and you work your way up and you create momentum. That might be efficient for some people, right? But that doesn't necessarily mean that they're gonna go what? Faster than if we were just judging the numbers. But when you add the human factor of an individual that's undisciplined, does not have a good track record of saving, has been in debt all their lives, mom and dad was in debt all their lives, grandma and grandpa was in debt all their lives, they got a whole multiple generations of debt. That's all they know is debt and borrowing. All they know is being a debtor, not a lender, right? All they know is being in debt, the borrower, but they know nothing of being lender. They know nothing of that language. Well, then this would be inefficient. They would not go as fast, no matter how good the numbers show. They would not go that fast. They would fail. Why? They don't have the culture yet. Maybe the culture of the kingdom. Maybe the culture of good money saving habits. Maybe the culture of increasing income. Maybe the culture of crisis versus opportunity. Did you know that the word crisis to the Chinese means opportunity versus Americans? When you look at the news, it says crisis, 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 crisis. To us, that means danger, 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 danger. Get away, go away. It's all bad, danger, danger. Go away, it's all bad. That's how Americans view crisis. The Chinese people, crisis, opportunity, 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 opportunity. Uh-oh, it's a different culture. So you have to understand who you're dealing with. For my financial coaches watching, consultants, people that are looking to implement velocity banking in your practice, sometimes you got to put the numbers aside and really identify, who am I looking at right now? What culture does my client have? What is their track record when it comes to money? Have they saved consistently? Have they invested consistently? Have they paid their tithes, give consistently? Do they just give consistently to an organization, to a business? Like, what have they done consistently with their finances that have created some sort of success? And we measure that. You say, okay, well, based on that, I like what you're doing there, Sue. I like what you're doing there, Tom, Joe, Mary. I like it. I like it. Here, we're going to implement this concept right here that can potentially produce some results. Okay?